The post office had two things to show off 70 feet below Paddington today. New trains for their 60-year-old private underground line, one of the little-mentioned wonders of London, and their new chairman, Sir Brian Nicholson. Booming letter business, he said, meant the post office's tube was busier than ever. The two new trains join 50 veterans, shuttling every 4 minutes between Paddington and sorting offices along the line at Whitechapel, 6.5 miles away. The driverless engines travel at 35 miles an hour, taking 26 minutes for the run. Today's new train set a record of under 13 minutes for a non-stop trip from Paddington to Liverpool Street. The line carries 8 million letters a day, with a great deal less hanging around than tube passengers face. It's a great success for the post office, contrasting with the industrial problems the new chief admitted he regularly faced above ground.
We've had special problems in London. It's very sad that a series of wildcat and guerrilla strikes, not supported either by the union leadership, and breaking negotiating procedures have led to a loss of customer confidence. That doesn't help jobs, so really what we're talking about is a very limited minority who are in a position to disrupt.
Could we see private services?
I certainly believe that a monopoly, which we have, is a privilege. It's not a right. And if we get it wrong, then we should expect others to have an opportunity to show how they can do the business.
The message from the post office chairman is that if disputes don't get sorted out above ground, private firms may be allowed to step into the lucrative business of delivering letters in London. Private operators, though, will find the high-speed rail mail hard to match. Simon Neave at Paddington's post office station.